Take the big gun.
You know, I know a lot of Harbor Freight stuff is absolute crap, but every once in a while, you know, it really makes a lot of sense. I mean, I paid a fraction for these cranes that I paid for the electric ones. And while they're not great, they certainly earned their keep. I'll keep them.
Really put a floor on here.
top of the tank is the floor of the cargo hold.
What? You can use these pieces of plates.
Yeah.
And use them as like a floor.
You think so?
Connect it to a wall over here.
That's a great idea.
Connect it to a wall. It can,
all those steel plates over there will fit right on top of here.
Uh-huh, and connect it to this,
and connect it to that. We're going to glue them to them?
Uh-huh.
Or should we weld them.
Or you could weld.
Yeah, I think welding.
That would hold it better.
Welding will hold it better, I think so, yeah. All
right. I just actually came up with that plan.
You came up with that plan?
Yeah.
Okay, awesome. What's down there?
A yellow S? Uh-huh.
Oh, it's for starboard.
Starboard. Because this metal came from starboard?
No, it's because that's the starboard side of the boat.
Oh, that's the name of it?
Yep. It's like right and left.
It goes that way?
Yeah, we want it to slope down a little bit because we're gonna put a pump there to suck the water out. It just needs to have a pump that sits down inside of it.
Here? Down?
No, I think about right here. We'll make it like 10 inches. Okay, then it goes over to that wall. Can you do that? Just like that. Roll it inside.
Down, right?
Okay, down. All the things I'm missing, good hugging, love, and kissing, are waiting at the end of my ride. You are not helping.
I know.
You are totally not helping me.
I know.
Okay. I can grind that down though. Yeah, it's good. Ah. Now we make the other side. You take a quarter inch off to that corner. And then it's gonna hump. We're about there. I think I'm going to do this is I'm going to put a weld in when I get both sheets sitting here that's going to fill down this and then down the sheet that's going to be here, and then I'll do a cover pass between the two, and I don't think I'll have to do any welding on the inside because I'm going to be welding into this corner, and I'm going to recess it a little bit, maybe not this much, but a little bit so I can push the weld bead down through that crack. Anyway, that's the plan. It always changes, so don't expect that to be the rule. And yeah, I know, I got this sheet in here and I was in a hurry that night. But you know, that shit to me just doesn't make any difference because water doesn't care. And it's a bent plate. It's actually a seam, a joint between two plates. And you know, my boat, I live with it. I like it.
Uh-huh.
Uh-huh.
little crazy.
Give me a flashlight. Get inside there.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, you're back. Over against the wall. You gotta leave room for me. There you go.
So you can open?
Yep. Then you gotta lay down. Get your head out of the way. You gotta stay still. Otherwise you'll smash your head.
Okay.
We don't wanna smash your head, do we?
No.
It's dark in here. You lighter in here? Are you scared of the dark, little boy?
No.
Are you scared? You got a flashlight.
No, when we combine them.
What if we turn your flashlight to see how dark it is?
Very scary.
Didn't scare you?
Not really.
A little bit of opening doesn't matter because we'll cut it and then it'll sit down inside. Because I'm marking it right to the inside of the plate. We could smuggle people in here.
What?
We could smuggle people in here.
Oh, we could make a hole and then while they walk away,
a spider hole, huh? You want to stab them when they walk by?
Uh-huh, we could do that too.
They wouldn't be expecting that, would they?
No, they wouldn't.
Jump up and hold them, scare them.
We could just surprise them and cut them in the foot, maybe.
You are vicious.
What does that mean?
It means you're cruel.
I make good ideas, you mean?
No, it means you're evil.
You mean I make good ideas?
No, that's not what it means.
I actually make good ideas.
I'm not saying that at all.
No, seriously, I make
no,
good ideas.
No, seriously.
I make good ideas.
Nice fit.
What?
It's a nice fit. Come look. We You got just a little bit of a, maybe, so listen, an eighth inch crack all the way around it. There's an eighth inch right there. But that'll be an easy weld. Nice gap in there. It goes down just a little bit. And then we're going to fill that piece between the two. See?
Why is this
to make
one
it watertight.
Why is this one liquid?
All of them are bent a little bit. And this one was bent upward. So I'm using this one. It's bent down. I use the bend with it.
This one's bent down?
Mm-hmm.
Why?
It's curved like this, which fits the boat better. But this one's no big deal. We just got to step on it and then weld it in place after you have a little weight on it. It's easy. You are dirty.
What?
You are dirty.
Right. Also, was my plan.
What?
This was my plan.
This was your plan to get dirty?
No.
I bet the kids are home now. You can go play.
I mean, move the, use the pieces.
Oh, yes.
You probably would have enough to put them.
This was your plan?
All right.
You sure?
Yes.
You're positive this was your plan?
Yes.
So am I doing it right?
It looks good, actually.
Okay. Well, good. I'm glad you're happy with
it. You can use the...
Wow. Good. How's that look? That's not bad. I'll do a little one right here at the top. Good job. How's that look?
Good.
Looks good? Let me see if I can break it off. Oh, that's good. You did a good job.
Okay. And then squeeze and hold gently. Go ahead. You're stopping. Why are you stopping? Did it scare you? All right, don't let it scare you. No, no, you're wiggling around too much again. Get in there. Put it in. Hold still. Move any closer. Maybe cut the wire off a little bit. Now get a little closer, a little higher up. And hold still when you start welding. A little closer. Alright. Anytime you're ready.
Yeah.
Okay. That's not bad, but that's still kind of a small weld. You need to weld for a longer time. Okay?
So,
I'm going to tell you when to stop this time, alright?
Okay.
Okay. So you're doing good. Just underneath where you were. Daddy, when you go, I'll start counting. Stop. Beautiful. See, that's about the long time that you need for attack. That's a good little weld. Okay? There's no way I could break that off. See? Well, okay, I can, but let's just ignore that. It's a little hot. Let me hit it again. Let me show you what I'm going to do. You watching? You watching?
Yes.
Okay. Yeah, work it going back and forth just a little bit as I come down. The other thing I'm doing that would help you is I put one hand on the steel to brace, and the other, and the torch is out here on my thumb. You're doing this out here in the air with two hands, it's a little harder. Okay? So if you can get your hand in here with your glove on.
To keep it in place?
Yeah, to keep it in place. That'll help a lot. Okay? Let's do another one. Okay? Start a little higher, and then come down with it. About 2 seconds worth. Okay? Yeah. When you're ready. Down a little bit.
Huh?
Go down with it a little bit. It's out the wire is glued on there, so there you go.
Again.
Yeah, get in closer. Use a nice little tack. Put one more in like that. A little lower, more angle. That would be right into it like that. There you go, go like that. Just jump on the side of it. There you go. Stop. Beautiful. That's gorgeous.
Thank you. Huh? Thank you for the compliment.
You have to earn the compliment. I don't just give them, okay? I'm not first grade. First grade gives a first place ribbon to everybody. I don't do that.
Right.
Okay, if I say it's good, it's good. If it's shit, I'll tell you it's shit, okay?
Right.
And that's being honest with each other, isn't it?
Right.
Okay, that was a good weld.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Yeah.
Oh, how's it look?
Right.
You like it?
Yeah.
Looks good? Yeah, it's on. That's all we need. Okay, four more. Well, you need a lot of practice, but so do I.
Because
you never get really good. Well, you can, but it takes a long time to get really good. Best way to do it is to start.
Is to start?
Yep. If you never start, you'll never get any better. I want you to be able to see the tip of the wire. Can you see the tip of the wire?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. You watch the tip of the wire and you watch the crack.
Okay.
Yep. There you go. Stop. See, that's beautiful. See, you just need to stand up where you can see it is all.
Great.
You want to put one below that?
That's good. How's that look?
Good.
Good, you sure? Give it a close look.
Yeah, it looks good.
Should be bonded to both sides. Yeah, that looks good. See if you can break it off. I see one way it should break and the other way it shouldn't.
Nope,
yeah, see, it's good. Yeah, but if you hit it with a hammer, you could break it, but that's good. You want to weld it on one side for that reason.
Now flatten that out. There you go.
There?
Yep, right into the corner. Now, can you reach your hand over so you can brace the hand on this wall? Very good. All right, let me move the part a little bit. Okay, when you're ready.
How is it?
It's on the wall.
What?
It's on the wall.
It's on the wall?
Yeah.
You jacked it up?
Yes.
Do it again. No harm. Nothing the grinder won't fix. Brace your hand. Get your hand up higher and brace it. Make sure it's going to shoot right where you want it to go.
There?
Yep.
Again.
How'd that look?
I can't mess up again.
You messed up again?
Went too much again. Just trigger it a little bit and it'll break the wire. There you go.
Yeah, see? You burned right on through it. Because you held it in one little spot for a little while, too long, and burned through. But it's okay, because it's pretty much on there. All right, let me hit it.
Yeah, let me fix the bottom of it. Now, to fix the bottom, all I did is I moved the torch from one side to the other like this.
So it'll dance back and forth. And it bridged over that.
But I didn't do that.
Well, you don't. The first thing you gotta do is learn to do tack welds, and you just move in a little straight line. Then you do larger, longer welds, and you move straight line. Then you can start learning to make little E's and little doodad stuff. But that's hard. That's later on. You did very good for what you did right here. Let's put the lid on.
You don't know my number.
I think you drop the steel on you, crush yourself.
Tops, and they're just cut and fit. They're not welded in yet. But here's what we're thinking about.
So that's the forward bulkhead, and these four tanks are water. This is one tank, and this is one tank with a baffle. And I've decided I'm going to cut a really huge hole in this, just leaving a flange, and then put a bigger piece of steel as a lid on this with a whole lot of bolts underneath that are threaded up through the plate. And that's a hatch, so I'll put a seal around that. And the reason for that is water tanks are notorious for their paint failing, and you got to get back inside and do something with it. So with a big hatch, I can get in there and I can sandblast it back, or worst case scenario, maybe even better when I have more time, is I can actually build a tank and just set right down inside of that thing and still have a hatch to bolt on, so I can keep salt water and other materials from going back down in there. These pockets or recesses in the corners are for drainage, and this is where the water is going to go off to, and bilge pumps will pick them up from there. And since these tanks are right next to this bulkhead, and there's going to be a companionway coming down through here and a hatch there, we're just going to put the fill and the vent pipes up this bulkhead probably for these tanks. So that's taken care of. Then the next four tanks are fuel tanks. One tank here, one tank here, and the mast actually steps down right on that that section right there, so it's kind of a structural thing for the mast too, since this is a 3/8 inch plates. That will serve as the vent for these tanks, the one vent on each side. And then the fill for these tanks, I've gone back to, you know, I thought about running them across the top, but that kind of makes me raise the deck. I'm going to put a wooden planked deck across all of this, and so I've figured out that it's not that big a deal to weld in a inch and a half pipe through these partitions or bulkheads, or sometimes they're just baffles. I actually thought about putting the hatches through here, and then, you know, a hatch in the next one, you could actually go through the tanks through the hatches. That sounded like absolutely no fun at all, though, and it looks like it's too much steel to take out. So I didn't want to weaken it that much. Instead, we'll go through this quarter-inch steel top rather than the 3/8-inch steel side. So each of one of these will get one of those round 18-inch hatches. Same thing with these fuel tanks back here. They'll have big hatches in them. So that's the way we can unbolt it, get inside the tank, clean it, maintain it, do whatever we need to do. And there's two more pockets back here for bilge pumps to pick up water. And then, so I think, yeah, I'm gonna definitely go through these. So one tank is going to get all the pipes. That'll leave the other one clear for being a bathtub if we want to use it like that. These will be wet or dry storage. They'll get a flange around them and some sort of a hatch that goes down over them so that the water will drain off to the side. And then I keep the water from going down in the keel. I'm going to put in probably a 2-inch, just a flat bar coming all the way down this. It'll act like a dam, so any water runs off, it hits that and then goes down to the drains either fore or aft. And I'll need some sort of a hatch to put over these, but there's batteries and, you know, chain, lead ballast and everything else down inside of here, so we'll need something where we can get to it easily. I think that's it. So I gotta get some pipe over before I start doing that, but I go ahead and burn the holes for it. And tomorrow I think I'll start cutting these big ones and making hatches for them. That'll be fun, because once I get that done, then I can start welding these plates in. And since I got them all cleaned up, I want to go ahead and start welding before they get too rusty.
So that's it. Sorry that was a long speech on boat stuff, but if you got some ideas on it, especially these hatches on the side, or maybe the gasket material for those lids for the fuel, drop me a comment. You always do, and I appreciate it. I actually read them, and I do pay attention to them. I just Don't get heartbroken if you get ignored, because, you know, it's me, and I'm not that smart. I'll muddle through it.